Hello, my name is Cobb Money and I'm the TV and audio editor at Trusted Reviews, and we have here Bowers and Wilkins brand new Pi7S2 true wireless earphones. So let's unbox and have a look. So these earbuds come in midnight blue, white and black. So these are the midnight blue version. They look pretty much identical to the previous model. Charging case appears to be the same, same sense of style as well for the earbuds as well. You've got the little touch control surface right there for operating the headphones. Charging case also has a feature that Bowers & Wilkins debuted a few years back with the original one, in which you can connect it to another device, say handheld console or in-flight entertainment, and you can retransmit audio from the case to the earbuds. Inside the case you've got quick start guide, you've got usual safety and warranty, and you've also got your earbud ear tip options as well, and your cables. This appears to be your charging cable. Let's just make a guess of that. And this is the cable that you use to retransmit audio to another device. So you can see it's got a 3.5mm jack. So the changes with the Pi7 aren't necessarily on the outside, but on the inside. For the Pi7S2, the battery life is longer, so they can go for 5 hours more than the original one, with an additional 16 hours from the charging case, although Bowers haven't actually stated how much it is with noise cancelling on. These also support fast charging as well. 15-minute charge provides 2 more hours of playback, and there is also wireless charging support if you are interested in charging through that method. In terms of water rating, these are IP54, which is actually very strong. Should be good resistance against solids or dust particles, stuff like that, or water resistance, so splashes of water basically. The drive units are pretty much the same as before, with 9.2 dynamic drivers with a balanced armature as well. In terms of noise cancellation, you've got 3 microphones per earbud for calls and noise cancellation, so that's 6 altogether. Bluetooth is the same as well. You've got SBC, AAC, aptX Classic, aptX HD, and aptX Adaptive. Although these do not appear to support Qualcomm's latest Snapdragon sound, which is interesting considering that these headphones portray themselves as offering true high-res audio quality on the move. The noise cancellation here is also adaptive, so it adjusts the noise cancellation automatically depending on how much noise it senses outside. You also have a transparency mode to let noise in for whenever you need to hear what's around you. Otherwise, that is pretty much it for the Pi7S2. They appear to be an upgrade in some ways, but in other ways they are pretty much the same as the original Pi7s. We'll be looking to do a review of them in the next couple of weeks, so stay tuned to Trusted Reviews for our review of the Pi7S2.